For the last few months, there has been a rise of AI devices on the launch. Just recently, a company called Open Interpreter released an AI agent device called O1 Lite. And just like other AI devices, like the Humane Pin and Rapid R1, which we have a video on, it's supposed to be a standalone device where it can talk to the device, and it will use AI to answer any questions or complete various tasks like checking an email, sending a message, or other things. In the demo shown by Open Interpreter, you can ask O1 to check a file on your computer and automatically send it via email.
Hey, that article should be on my desktop. It's called the Universal Interface.
There's a file titled the universalinterface.pdf on your desktop. Do you want me to send it to Mike?
Now, at this point, I could ask my Lite to read or even edit that document, but I'm just going to send it to Mike. Yes, please send it.
It can also monitor your email for certain attachments, just like shown in demo.
Okay, now I want you to monitor my email. If you get any invoices, could you take a look at the attachments and then Slack all the relevant details to Mike?
All right, I'll monitor your inbox for invoices. If I see one, I'll Slack the details to Mike. I just sent a Slack message to Mike with the basic information of the invoice.
Also, just like Rabbit R1, it has a mode where you can teach the AI to do something. But unlike Rabbit R1, you don't need to type or click on the computer. You just need to say what O1 needs to do on the screen, and O1 will do that itself.
Hey, I want to teach you something.
Sounds good. What do you want to teach me to do?
I'm going to show you how to send a Slack message.
Okay, I'm ready. What's the first step?
First, open Slack.
It looks like Slack is open. Did I do that right?
Yeah, you did. Okay, now you can write the message. For example, hey Ty, then press enter.
It looks like I've sent the message, is that right?
Yes, and that's all there is to this skill, so you can save it now.
I've just learned the skill send a Slack message.
The O1 Lite uses an open source language model called Llama. And this is the key differentiator between Open Interpreter's O1 and other AI agents like Rabbit R1 or the Humane AI PIM. Being an open source means that people can build whatever feature on top of it, and while the device would cost you $99 pre-order, you can try the AI feature on your devices for free. Now, while it is interesting to see the rise of AI agents devices such as O1, Humane AI PIM, or the Rabbit R1, there are some strong criticism towards it. And one YouTuber called Dave2D voiced some interesting critiques. Mainly, he criticized that these products struggle to answer, why use this instead of our phone? For example, you can ask O1 to check your text messages or email, but isn't pulling up your phone more private and faster? Or you can take R1 to suggest what food you should cook based on what you have in the fridge, but why is it a device and not an app in the App Store?
They basically do what your phone does, but they're just not as good at doing it. Your phone's better at it.
That means you can use it however you want.
Like what? Tell me something you would use that for.
So you use it for just about anything, like sending texts or checking up on any notifications that you've got in.
Why is it not an app? Like, why is this a piece of hardware that you have to buy? Why isn't it just something you can download from the App Store or the Play Store?
Another criticism he voiced is that when it comes to certain things like ordering food or getting taxi or planning vacations, there's a lot of things that you consider that will lead us to different choices. Maybe you'll order a taxi and see the high cost and decide that you'll rather go across the street and make it $5 cheaper. Or maybe you have specific days in restaurants for your vacations. And these tiny details that go into our decision-making may be overlooked by an AI that takes actions in mere minutes.
And also, errors, like AI hallucinations. You're talking about ordering 50 pizzas, booking a vacation that's $20,000 over budget.
Moreover, because they are physical devices, you need to carry them. And that usually means you carry them along with your phone and maybe even your laptop when working. It can become a hassle to carry another additional device, and some of them, like Rabbit and O1, need you to hold them to start speaking, making it not a hands-free experience. At that point, why not just use your phone and laptop since you're already in front of him most of the time? This is the biggest challenge that these AI device companies need to answer. How are their devices better than a smartphone? And while yes, some may argue that these devices may help with our screen addiction and low attention span caused by it. But if using it proved to be less practical or enjoyable, we may still have to wait for a better solution. What do you think? Are these AI devices just gimmicky? Or is there a lot of potential in it? Let us know what you think in the comments. Hi, thank you for watching until the end of this video. And if you like it, please like a video and subscribe for more videos like this. MAlpha.ai is an AI platform where you can create digital avatar of yours and even create images using AI for free. Try it at MAlpha.ai now.